OMG guys, you guys will not believe what I just discovered. Oh my gosh guys, this is pretty cool news. Mabuhay squad. Check out what I just saw right now.
Hey guys, welcome to my daily vlogs. Please subscribe.
My composter is growing squash. Guys, this is my composter right here. It's full of worms and all these soil creatures. And we put our biodegradables in here, like Ligaya's leftover vegetables, clippings and stuff. And I guess some squash seeds were in Ligaya's bowl and I threw them in here, not even thinking that they would sprout, but they've sprouted. Oh my goodness. So I've been thinking then, I think I'm just gonna let this grow, like out of the composter, and we'll grow a squash plant. How neat. Very, very neat. And then maybe we could like transplant it to the Mabuhay Squad farm. What do you guys say? And this soil, as gross as it looks, excuse me, because like some of the stuff is growing mold, which is part of the decomposition process. Mm-hmm. As gross as this is, the soil is really, really full of nutrients for plants because of, well, you know, the worms that eat all of this stuff. They're like casts and they're release this like urine, I guess, that is full of nitrates, so good for plants. So this squash here is going to be like, it's strong, it's full, it's nourished, it's gonna be nice and flourishing. Ooh, I can't wait. I think what I'll do is I'll allow the plant to come out here. I'll wait till its stalk becomes, I guess, stronger and thicker, and then I'll just like maybe create a little space for it to come out, and it'll grow out of here. This, by the way, is our AC nucleus for those of you who follow the ANTSCANADA channel. How cool. By the way guys, welcome to the daily vlogs. My name is Mikey Bustos. This here's Ligaya, the African Grey. Be sure to hit the like button if you enjoyed this vlog and hit the subscribe button to join the Mabuhay Squad. We will be your daily dose of positive vibes online. OMG guys, I got some great news. Mm-hmm. All right, so I've been vocalizing a lot these days because I'll be performing at a few places so far this year. So just wanna go over the dates. Of course, we have May 9th, Mother's Day. Big concert in Toronto, that's at the CNE grounds, and I'll leave information, and in the description box we'll also leave information there where you can get tickets. That is official. I will see you guys in my hometown, Toronto. Woo! Okay, and then second of all, I've got some great news. So I was supposed to perform in March in Australia, but then that show got postponed because of the whole bushfires. Like, I didn't want to go to Australia and be like, yeah, I'm gonna do a show when people are still kind of like in recovery mode, you know what I'm saying? So the good news is we have official dates for the Australia shows. Yes, Australia shows. So get this, all of you Mabuhay Squad over in Melbourne, Australia, I'll be performing in Melbourne, July 4th. Yes, so I will see you guys there. You awesome people in Melbourne. I really miss you guys in Melbourne. And then July 5th, the next day, I get to meet all of you awesome folks in Sydney, Australia. Yes, so fun. If you guys live in any of these cities, be sure to bring your family, bring them along. I'd love to meet you guys. I'm sure there's a meet and greet arrangement somehow. We'll leave details of the tickets in the description box, yes? And look forward to meeting you. So this is what my show is. It's basically a variety show. It's family friendly. Well, pretty much. So you can bring your kids, bring your parents, bring all that. You don't need to be Filipino to appreciate the show. And it's a mix of comedy, a mix of singing of my parodies that you guys love on YouTube. And there's even a section where I'm singing like serious songs. And I do a little bit of stand-up comedy too in between the sets. So it's like a whole bunch of stuff. The show is about an hour and a half. And I look forward to meeting you guys after the show. Yes, spread the word. Love it.
Guys, look at how beautiful the fish tank looks at night. Isn't it so calming? I really, really love it. It's so serene. It's just so calming. Oh, I love like just staring at this tank. Look at the roots from the floating lettuce, the water lettuce. It's really getting longer. And we have the kabomba back there doing really well. The red ivy doing well. The tripartita sending out runners. So it's slowly creeping along the floor as planned. Yes. I am so grateful to be able to look at this. It's such a good eye refresher. You know what I mean? Like if ever I just want to chill and like relax, I just need to look here. That's it. and like my eyes are relaxed. It almost puts you in a trance. You know what I'm saying? I really, really love this tank. And the fish are just so, they float. You know what I mean? It's no wonder that fish tanks allegedly lower blood pressure. They're just super relaxing. This is my little indoor garden, guys. Because I can't have a big outdoor garden.
The guy is asleep. Yes.
I put her to bed.
And I myself will be going to bed soon. It's 8:04. I like sleeping early, guys. And I like waking up early. Such a good feeling, right? Gonna drink water. Gotta hydrate. As per my mom's instructions, hydrate yourself, she says. Don't let your throat dry out. My mom is coming, OMG, in like 6 days. Oh no, wait, February. She's coming in like 4 days or 3 days. Sorry, I'm bad at math. I tried to convince my mom not to come because like of this whole coronavirus thing. Sadly, unfortunately, the Philippines had a second case of coronavirus, which is the husband of the girl who was confirmed to have coronavirus. So it was a husband and a wife, and the husband passed away. So sad. So the couple, they're from Wuhan. They're not Filipinos, but it's just so tragic. So the husband passed away and he's only 44. And I've been seeing like online this like thing about, you know, don't worry if you get coronavirus because it usually is only fatal for like really young kids or people with previous like immunity issues, right? Or like the elderly, like that. But this guy, I believe, was a 44-year-old healthy individual and he passed away. So like, that's scary. I really hope that they contain this coronavirus because, oh, freaking us out. Anyways, good night, Mabuhay Squad. Let's be positive. Mm-hmm. Lots of exciting things coming up. A brand new day tomorrow. Good night, Mabuhay Squad.
Good morning. Morning, the guys. You waiting for me?
Yep.
I'm here.
Yes.
Good morning to you.
Good morning, Mabuhay Squad. Another day. Sindiarit! It's a Monday today, isn't it?
Yes.
Beautiful Monday morning, Super Bowl Monday morning. I just saw the performance of Demi Lovato. Sorry, the beatbox went off. And she did an incredible job at the Star Spangled Banner. Congratulations. Demi Lovato, honestly, I don't really watch sports, but I do watch the Super Bowl for two things, the performances and the commercials. So I'm looking forward to those coming out on YouTube and social media soon.
Yes, guys.
Breakfast time?
I think so.
Gotta wash the dishes as usual. You know our usual routine here, right? Aunt Ellsie is probably on her way here. How are you guys this Monday morning, huh? Do you guys watch the Super Bowl? I know it's a very big thing in the US and Canada as well. Super Bowl Sunday. Here it is Monday morning, so people actually go to the bar to watch Super Bowl. It's pretty incredible. But generally... Oh my god, come here! Step up. You wanna step up? How about the shoulder? Step up. There you go. Oh, no?
Do you wanna shower?
Shower, shower, shower. Okay, maybe she doesn't.
Alright.
Dishes washed.
Bird is eating breakfast. Yes. Breakfast is served.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a fruit day.
Got some apples in there.
Mmm. I love feeding this bird.
So this morning I am putting on some Mozart. Yes, this is Allegro. Einklein Nach Musik. Yep, Allegro. They say if you listen to music, it somehow makes you smarter. There's like even a baby playlist that you can play for your baby of Mozart music to make your baby smarter, apparently. Interesting. But I like the vibes. Very nice vibes this morning.
Good morning, Ate. We're up for our next positive affirmation of the day. Ooh. Monday, February 3rd. I am perfect, whole, and complete, just as I am. I love me. Say it, guys. I am perfect, whole, and complete, just as I am. I love me.
All right.
Look at how smart this bird is. So I put like pellets and like some sunflower seeds and cardamom seeds in her foraging toy. She gets it with her mouth, drops it into her food bowl because she knows there it'll be easier to eat. Wow! You're so smart, bird. What's going on here? Huh? Such a smart bird. And guys, she's really eating the pellets from here. Now I'm thinking I'm just gonna serve her pellets from here from now on. I'll put some in her bowl, but I feel like this is really good enrichment for her for a nice change to put some of her pellets in here. Gets to use her brain a little bit and work for her food. Yes, guys, you just gave me a good idea. She's extra eager for these pellets because she knows she only gets them in the afternoon. This is like an early bird, no pun intended. Pellet treat. There's one more here. I'll scratch you later. Go ahead. Sorry, I interrupted.
Yes, we are off. Going for our outdoor stroll through the neighborhood to soak up some sun. Yes, right, guys? Bird loves these walks and she benefits from all of the stimulation. Mm-hmm. And you know what? Also, as soon as we get a puppy in May, in case you don't know, my cousin's puppy is like pregnant. And he's vowed to give us one of the children. So I imagine that come May, when this puppy, if all things goes well and as planned, comes to live with us, I'm gonna be going on walks with Ligaya and the puppy. It'll be the two of us. Can you imagine? A bird and a little tiny dog. Now, I wonder how it's gonna work on the farm because, oh my gosh, guys, look. OMG, it's a dead lizard. And ghost ants have found it. OMG, this is like a real life ANTSCANADA video. Seriously. Wow, it's a skink. Guys, this is a native skink. These are the skinks that live in the neighborhood. Wow, I've never been able to see them this close because they are so fast and they disappear so quickly. Whoa, that's crazy. See that, guys? These ghost ants are having a feast.
Anyways, as I was saying, I wonder how it's gonna work on the farm because the dogs that we will be getting, and yes, we need to get dogs, and not just the small puppy, we need to get large dogs because one, for security, but also there are snakes. And not just any snakes, guys. There are reticulated pythons, the longest snake in the world, but even more dangerous because reticulated pythons aren't so dangerous. They're dangerous for our livestock, like our chickens and all of that. But even more dangerous for us people are the Philippine cobras. Yes, the Mabuhay Squad Farm has Philippine cobras. So we plan on getting large dogs to hopefully scare these cobras away. And these cobras are dangerous because not only are they venomous and like can kill people, they spit their venom so they can blind you. Of course, they only do this when they feel cornered. If they had a choice, they run. They don't like people. They're afraid of people and hopefully dogs. But anyways, yeah, so we're gonna get a few dogs, but do you still have to take dogs for a walk? Even if they have like a massive like property to run around in? I think you do, right? The stimulation of like the outside world excites dogs. Is that not true? Like when you go on a walk, like new, like a trail? I don't know. Let me know, guys. But I bet when we move to the new farm, the bird will be living in the aviary, so she'll get a lot of sun. I think these walks will be maybe not so frequent as every day. I don't know, we'll see. I like going for walks anyways. Right, guys? It's so refreshing to go on these walks. You know what I love? Growing up in my neighborhood, I grew up with a lot of Italians. Like, every other house in my neighborhood was an Italian family. And what I love about Italians is they go for walks, like late afternoon walks around the block. They go, hey, and they wave to the neighbors as they pass by and they chat. I really like that, afternoon walks. It's really nice. Like even the seniors, like as old as 70 years old with their cane, like they would walk around the neighborhood. I found that really neat.
And something I definitely want to adapt. Oh, guys, look at this. Awesome vines. Oh my gosh, this would be amazing in an aviary. The guys want to step up?
Step up? Yep, it's safe. Ooh, awesome. Isn't that fun? Cool.
She's kind of wary. This is her first time on a branch. On this branch, I mean.
Cool, right? Do you like it?
Maybe not as interesting as the guava tree that you're used to, but change is good, right?
Uh-oh, I don't like that you can climb so high.
No, the guys, don't climb too high. I won't be able to get you.
I love this bird. Oh,
I even love when she poos.
Do you like it?
Yes.
This is actually, I think, is this private? Oh my gosh, this is private property. Okay, Ligaya, we gotta go. Come, good girl. We're not allowed here. That was a cool grapevine, right? I don't even know if that was grape, but it was a cool vine branch. I can't wait to design your aviary, guys. Mm-hmm. The outdoors will be your domain.
Oh, look at this, guys.
A rooster. Hi there. Guys, roosters on the sidewalk, tied on the leg like that, are a common sight. It's a little sad because cockfighting is a very common, sport and game here in the Philippines. It's kind of cruel, but I mean, when the rooster dies, the losing rooster, I mean, they eat them. Like, it doesn't go to waste.
What are you doing? You're playing with my hat.
OMG, my boy squad. I don't want Ligaya to learn that crow. Don't copy that bird, okay? She was listening. Guys, we're taking pictures. Hello.
Despacito.
Ay, salamat. My despacito. I wear speedos.
Speedo.
Yes, because we're Filipino, we're taking pictures. What's your name?
Jojo, sir.
Hi, Jojo. Are you making a delivery?
Yes, sir. Fruit panda.
Oh, awesome. All right. See you later. Bye bye. All right. Love meeting new people. Really, guys? We love meeting new peeps. OMG, guys. You won't believe what we're doing right now. There's Attn Ellsie. RJ, guys, look at our ceiling. Major operations.